Okay, Don back. Well, that's as best I can get a view of that screen. And I've got it up in my way where I can't see the monitor. But I can read that well enough since I'm used to this screen. So English, this is the boot screen of VBA Rescue. That's the first thing it'll ask you. And I hit OK, and it should just go right on, finish booting. But it hasn't done anything. I've let it sit here for 30, 40 minutes messing with these phones, trying to get them to work. And I've switched off, I switched off of this machine into my other one, plugged the phone in and copied the videos. And so I think I've lost my capture of my USB keyboard. So, and I've been sitting here for a little bit while I was getting the phone ready. Yeah, the keyboard's not doing anything. And when you're in a, especially one of these, just for whatever reason, the ones that are not graphic user interfaces, but I mean, it does have a graphic, and we're obviously looking at one, but the ones that are just basically set up for lower resource machines, less memory, less processing power, they don't put as much automatic hardware recognition in it. So, yeah, I guess a lot of them, the ability to find the USB again, I'm using a KVM switch to switch between machines, but use the same monitor and keyboard. And the KVM switch actually has a signal, a VGA signal sent out to the computer. I mean, of course, it's made to receive the signal, but it does something. There's also something sent back. I don't know. I just remember reading that when I bought it. It'll tell your computer there's a monitor, even when you're not on it, when you're off on another machine. So it keeps you from losing your... it helps somehow. I actually don't lose your VGA because I've done it without a switch. Computers will always send out your signal no matter what. I'm out in the garage, I got three machines out there that I'll just move my... I'm just moving my monitor cable anytime I want. It doesn't make any difference. It takes a second, third of record, you know, get to the monitor and come on. So anyway, that was beside the point, wasn't it? The point is the USB. Over the years, I've had this switch since, I don't know, like 02 or something, 2002. Over the years, I've learned that in practical application of it, that there's generally the ones that will lose the USB connection when you switch off of them are the ones like this. And you know, like a lot of the others that are full-blown operating systems, full-blown domain or Linux, instead of like a... This is what I guess I would call a CLI. It's a command line. They call it command line interface, but basically they have a graphic wizard in them. Or sometimes it's just a text wizard, but this one's a little more because it actually has graphics in it. But anyway. I'm turned around because I've had all kinds of trouble. I was using the other phone holding it, and it, you know, I wanted to make it show up, and I tried on this one, the one I got sitting in the cassette, set up in the cassette holder so that it can be like a tripod for it. It locked up while I was changing settings in it, and I thought, well, I'll leave it alone for a while, and never did come back. I kept trying as hard to shut it down like you would a computer, and it wouldn't respond. So then I went to messing with the other phone, and I got my settings figured out. But then in the meantime, something went wrong with open camera, which has happened before on that phone. And now it won't, when you try to take a video, it'll begin to start, and then it'll quit trying to take the video. The application doesn't crash, but it won't take a video. And the only way I could get it to work again before was to uninstall Open Camera and reinstall it. It's the only thing I could figure out. And on this one, though, it finally responded to my buttons, and I got it to actually went right back to working normally. I made a video of a test video, and then I went ahead and rebooted it for good measure to make sure everything was back to normal. And suppose it should be working, except for my machine's not responding. And I've sat here long enough to see. I can hit my keys on my keyboard. It's not going to find it. Sometimes it just takes a little longer. Sometimes that switch even acts up, and you can switch around to a different machine. I can actually let you see that. Oh, it'll just be showing the middle of my other screen. Okay, so that's my machine I have running. It's asleep now. It goes to sleep every 10 minutes no matter what, and I can't get that to quit. So that's my desktop background. You can see just a little bit of it. And so you can see the mouse. It changes automatically. Where's the mouse? So, and when I switch back, I'll do that just to make sure that's not the only thing that was actually wrong is that it just didn't take good. You can see the monitor's adjusting, and so by this time I should be able to use my mouse and keyboard, but I can't. So it ain't coming back. The best remedy for that is to plug a PS2 keyboard into that machine, and then you can just pick it up and use it. And a lot of times with some of these older machines, some of them are real. We'll do this because of their BIOS, but this is not an older machine; it's a newer one. So that's the way I usually get around it. Let me see. I don't believe I have one plugged into it. I have one over here. Yeah, that's plugged into my old server. Yeah. Now, the other one, I have two over there sitting. And there's one sitting on top of the S-Rock, but that's plugged into my server. That's a PS2 keyboard. I can't show it. I could, but it'd be no point in it. And then, yeah, there's another one in my other older machine that I leave it in there because it's prone to doing that a lot. So that way I'm not hung up, you know. So I am hung up. So now what do I do? If I hard shut down with this SD card, I run the risk of getting the machine out of whack, and it won't recognize my SD card for however long it's mad at me. So I'd do something to make. I don't know. Last time, I never did figure out how I got it working. Last thing I did was, I had been booting it into USB sticks. It would recognize them just fine. This is the SD card on a USB adapter, and I would mount it, see if that would get it to see it, get the BIOS to see it. It wasn't working, and then the last thing I did was swap them in their slots, and it booted just fine. And the thing is, no, I should have checked on that. I can't do anything that involves keyboard or mouse because it's not recognizing them. Okay, so I can't do Control Alt Delete or anything. See, rebooting it would be fine, you know. But now I'm sitting here going, okay, so is it going to recognize? I guess I'll find out. I'm just going to leave it running and see what happens. Shut it down. Okay, it seemed like it took the 4 seconds or more. So maybe it is set on 4 seconds. I just kept saying it seemed like it wasn't set on 4 seconds. Okay, now it's rebooting. Nothing's come up yet. Okay, now that's a close-up view, just the center of the screen, but it's showing my options. Oh yeah, it's trying to go back into Windows, just like I was afraid of. Okay. I'll hard shut it down again. I'll turn it on. It'll go back into Windows again, and I'll just hard shut it down again, and then I'll put my SD card in there. Let's see. No, it won't help to go into BIOS. There's no settings in there. This is a weird BIOS. There's no settings in there. Okay, depending on what state it's in, as to whether it's how fast it shuts down. That's pretty weird.
I guess it does that a lot, and I just forget. Okay, I put it back in there in the same slot it was in. See if it does it again. Oh, yeah. Okay, so which one has that?
Okay, I remember an idea. Let's wait. I was about to shut it down before it. Same problem. Okay, I'm going to leave it in the slot it's in. I'm going to grab my... This is what I was getting ready to do the last time, and then it didn't... it worked. I'm going to put my other... Rescue. One of them says rescue, and the other one's red. The text is off. One of them was where I could read it, but now... when you touch the marks a lot on these things... Oh, okay. This one says Sardu Rescue. Like that matters enough to bump into the camera, but I don't know. Showing nothing just seems weird on a video to me. Talking and showing a black screen. Okay, so I'm putting it in there. I'm leaving the SD card USB adapter in the one slot it was already in, and put my Sardu USB stick. The reason I'm using the Sardu one is because it has... I might have to move the camera for this to make any sense whatsoever. So I'll go ahead and do it because I know... Well, wait, I'm about to get to the point. Okay, tools. I'm going to try to move the boxes and everything. It's not helping. It's not tall enough. Still not tall enough. Okay, I'm gonna hold it because this is getting ridiculous. Okay, I was all trying to be still, you know. Yeah, that worked. Okay, so, Plot Boot Manager. That is a real cool boot manager that'll help you boot into just about anything. And it's not showing all the way up on the screen. It's not... I'm cutting it off, but it's... let's do that. Usually, well, let's see. A lot of times if you turn the monitor off and turn it back on, it'll adjust. Sometimes it will, sometimes it won't. Sometimes if you flip on over to the other machine, let it adjust for that, and then flip back, it'll adjust. Okay, but it's not doing it. Now I can hit keys on the monitor and make it adjust, and that's hard to do, period, for me. Oh yeah, see, now we got back to these screens that won't show up. I'm gonna go ahead and do it. As much of a pain as it is. How do I adjust? Because I never can remember. See, now I've adjusted the wrong thing. Full fit. Okay, that's what I want there. I never can remember which button to hit. What makes sense to me doesn't make sense to the machine. I lose track of where I am. Okay. There. It is not working. Ugh. Okay, I was just wanting to show the whole screen. It will work sometimes, and sometimes it won't. It's something about the way this thing, this particular little operating system but there's more up there. There's hard drive one, and it'd be the hard drives and stuff up above there.
twisting my arm on stuff that's not actually helping. My boxes are moving around. Okay, so I don't think it's focusing too well. Bottom one is USB, but okay, so you see you can't see all the devices. That's pretty aggravating. Okay. There's 4, 5, and 6. It's usually not a huge problem like it is right now, but not working right. I can't even, I'm just going to hit enter. Oh, you got to hit a number. See, I don't know which one's the one I want. Probably be guessing anyway. And just because it says, that doesn't actually mean it recognizes. It's recognizing the ports, not that there's something in the port. Yeah, so I said what a great boot manager it is. But it does have its aggravations too. So I'm gonna hit 4 for grins. Let's see. Nope. Okay, that's not even doing anything. Since I can't see where I'm at on there, I can't even do it right. If you ever get up, I think I want to do this right now, but I just woke up and I hardly know what I'm doing. But I just want to do it so bad, I'm gonna do it. And then you get into the biggest mess you've been into in a week. Well, that's what I did today. Control Alt Delete. You're not working. Okay, hard shutdown. Heck, maybe I lost the keyboard, is what my problem was. I shouldn't have. Okay. You're just going to see part of the screen right now. Everything's out of whack now with the screen. Oh, I think I put it on fit instead of fill, and I think fill is what I want. Yeah. I never can remember. I'll try to just leave it alone because I forget. Yeah, fill is what I want. Okay, get out of there. I believe that's the way I like it. Okay, menu tools. Yeah. More than one boot. Wait a minute. Not in here, I guess. Plop is the only thing in here. I was thinking there were some other things like... Right. Super grub disc. Okay, I'm gonna move these boxes out of my way. They're causing me to just fumble around. I can rest my arm on the chair better, and now I can get to my keyboard. Okay, yeah. Super grub disc 2. It just helps you to boot when you got problems booting. So I think maybe it'll find my. Should find my now you have to, if you have never used this before, you got to keep reading all these things to see what to do. I've gone through it lots of times, so I'm just going to keep hitting enter. Wait a minute. Oh, free magic is broken at. I got a problem. Sometimes you have to read. Control Alt delete. Well, we're gonna make an hour long video of me fumbling around and getting nowhere. Looks like it. Okay. That was super grub disk. Antivirus Linux. What's in Linux? Netboot Fedora. Okay, not gonna help. I tried that before, booting into a Fedora operating system and mounting that SD card, and it didn't help. Super Grub Disk will actually fix a broken grub, but we don't have a broken grub. Go try plop again, just see if it would accidentally. No, so maybe I can figure it out. Okay. I'm gonna use a tab. I think you have to get it over into the right menu. I was thinking you could just use your arrow keys. Yeah, see, it says port 5. It doesn't say use number 4 or 5. Since I can't see what's going on, I don't know why it's not responding. Control Alt Delete. I'm losing the keyboard. That's what's happening. Maybe it's because I hit the right arrow key a minute ago. I figured out a while ago. I'm going to try something here. There, look at that. I figured out how to turn on the light manually. So yeah, so here's what I've got. I've got my USB stick I'm running on, and under there, where you can't see, is my little SD card and the USB adapter, and those are all the SD card readers that don't work because it got shorted out by the previous owner jamming stuff in there and bending up the pins. So I'm going to take out this one, take them both out, and put this one in another slot. I don't think it'll help, but that is kind of what happened last time that made it work. I think the one in the bottom will boot first if it's recognized. Oh, up here. It'll probably just go into Windows again. Yep. Still don't want it to go into Windows because I'm not finished cleaning it up. I don't want it to, if there's something left, I don't want it to, going in there and allowing it to spread again. So, I still got that light on. I'll run the battery down super fast. Okay, it's not helping me at all. I put it back in there like that. Put it in the bottom one. It doesn't. I've booted this thing many times to different. Either one of those slots. That's not what matters to it. It matters that it can. BIOS can just see that what you're booting to. I'll hit F11 for grins. That has never helped before. See, it just can't see anything but the hard drive and the DVD. Now I have plop on CDs and DVDs, and generally when I use those, I don't have the problem of the menu being off the screen like that and not being able to get it to fit. So I don't know why it's doing that on the one I have on my SD card, but of course that won't do anything. I just hit CD, DVD, tried to went on default, it just went past, couldn't find it, and then went back to the. So I'm gonna just
turn it off, take this out, and I'm going to turn off my little, I don't know if I've ever showed this real good, SD card is in there, it's a little phone size micro SD I think they call it. That's my regular USB stick, one of them. I'm going to turn off this light.